Good afternoon, guys. This is your Sir DRV again, and welcome back to our Mythic Heroes channel. And for this video, we will be going to talk about another hero. We will be reviewing this hero, and I can say that this hero was in the middle tier before, but after the buff, he was actually pushed through the top tier. And before we start reviewing this hero, let me just give a shout out to these people. Number one is Jamelzia. Thank you very much for adding me in your GC. And Izamami, shout out to you. And for one of my moderator, Soul Stealer, thank you very much. And Mistra, one of my avid fan. Raffly and Jerry Indoy, who is always watching from the Philippines. All right, so shout out to you guys. Thank you very much for supporting me. All right, so let's move on to the hero that we'll be reviewing today. I'm talking about Oberon. So, yep, one and only Oberon that got recently buff and he actually become a beast. So, before we go through the review, let me just show you some UI changes. As you can see before, there was a small sword on each of the hero if you unlock the weapons, right? After Mythic, now it becomes a star. As you can see, most of my heroes already have a star on the upper left side of the border. So let me just give you an example how to make it appear. So as you can see, my Persephone doesn't have any star. So in order for you to unlock the star on the upper right hand corner, all you need to do is to increase the divinity up until at least level 2. And there you go. You will now see a star on the upper right hand corner. You see? All right. Another changes on the UI is, as you can see on the left side, there is another square on the upper left on the hero on one of my main lineup. Let's say, for example, Izanami. The red Shadow Arch icon have 4 red borders, right? As you can see, my Persephone doesn't have those borders. That is because my weapon is not upgraded yet. So for every circle or every upgrade, it will add another border. Let's say, for example, this one, Hades. My Hades is only weapon 200. So that's the reason why he only have 2 borders unlocked. So it's just a good to know, guys. All right, I just recently noticed it, so I just wanted to share it to you guys. All right, so let's move on to Oberon. All right, so one of his best buff skill as of the moment is the Homecoming, which is his ultimate. Oberon throws his blade at the furthest enemy in the field and disappears. As the twin blades are traveling, they deal 250% damage to all enemies in their way. Alright, so previously, this was, I think, only 100%+ damage. Now it's 250, which is a massive increase. And when the blades reach their destination, they pause for 1.5 seconds and then deal 100% damage every 5 seconds. 0.5 seconds to nearby enemies. After Oberon appears again and catches the blades, dealing 250% damage to nearby enemies again. So before, it was way less as well for that. Okay, at level 2, the blades deal 300 damage. At level 3, the blades deals 120% damage to enemies near the destination. At level 4, when Oberon appears and catches the blades, they deal 300 damage to nearby enemies. So, yeah, this is a major buff. His ultimate can actually rival those current damager that we have right now. So if you guys are using Oberon, good for you, because he was definitely buffed so hard. All right, next will be the Swirling Blades. Oberon slashes with its twin blades, deal 4x60% damage to target, increases dodge by 35% for 3 seconds. So this is one of his survivability skills, dodge. Aside from this, he has another dodge skills on the weapon upgrade, so we will be talking about that later. All right, so at level 2, 65%, at level 3, 70%, at level 4, 75%, which is massive if you multiply it by 4. Okay, next, another good skill for Oberon is this Storm of Blades or Spinning Blades. All right, so Oberon spins his blade, blocking all damage and debuffs for 3 seconds. So whenever Oberon spins his blades, he is immune to damage, okay? Those damages that he received, he is immune, but it is actually calculated. All right, so he actually reflects those damage back to enemies. So let's just read the deal. Number 2, deals additional damage equal to number of block attacks during the skill times 40% to a maximum of 200% damage. Okay, so he can actually return back those damages for a maximum of 200%. At level 3, deals 135. At level 4, deals 150% damage. So this is one of the more useful skill of Oberon. Aside from his dodge, he also have this immunity, and he also have another dodge skill. So he is actually getting more, let's say, tankier. He can survive more damages right now. Alright, so the last one is the Twin Blades. When Oberon uses auto attacks, he switches blade to inflict different effects. The left blade removes 20 energy from the target. The right blade deals an additional 1.5% true damage. When Oberon uses any skill, both blades effect will be added. Alright. At level 2, the right blade deals 1.8% of true damage. Level 3, the left blade removes 25 energy from the target. At level 4, the right blade removes 2.1% of target's max health. Alright, good skills. Definitely one of the best buff skills right now is the Homecoming. And the most useful ultimate or skill, sorry, is the Storm Blades. All right, let's talk about the weapon. So for weapon 100, it increases attack speed by 20% for 3 seconds after using a skill, which is good. Increasing attack speed by 30% for weapon 200, increase attack speed by 40% for weapon 300, and increase dodge by 75% for 8 seconds after releasing Homecoming for the weapon 400. So let me just give you some opinion about weapon 100, 200, 300. I can say that this is not really important for Oberon. Those extra attack speed, it's not really important. The most important here is the weapon 400. So if you're using Oberon, make sure to rush his weapon to weapon 400. All right, so let me just explain to you why saying attack speed is not really important for him. Okay, so let's go with the weapon and artifact. All right, so there are different artifact that Oberon can use. Number one is the air rune, which utilizes the twin spinning blades, the Storm of Blades. So the more Oberon uses the Storm Blades, the more Oberon can survive or have longer survivability in the battle, which is very good in campaign. Alright, so I suggest if you're using Oberon in campaign, you can use Air Rune, okay? Also, to maximize his ultimate, I suggest you use Chakra as well. Okay, Chakra and Air Rune. Okay, so that's my opinion about the artifacts and weapon. But if you're using Oberon in PvP, then it will be a different scenario. So Oberon, when he uses the twin blades, have or the spinning blades, the storm of blades, she will return back the damage maximum of 200%, right? So we will be utilizing the increased crit chance by 15% in the next 20 seconds. So I believe Oberon will be using those storm of blades or spinning blades before the 20 second ends, and that will be beneficial in PvP battle, because PvP battles will end pretty soon or pretty fast actually. All right, so aside from that, as you can see, there is a divinity that you can use for Oberon. Let's go to the divinity. Okay, here it is, the spotlight. Hero's attack cannot be dodged. Additionally, every 1% of hero accuracy is converted into 2% of crit damage for the battle. So how much accuracy does Oberon have? As for me, Oberon have 8.8% accuracy. If we multiply that by 2, that will be 16 or 17% crit chance. So Oberon already have 15.2% crit chance for me. If we add the 17, that will be 32 plus. And then if we add the crit chance from the fire rune, which is 15%, that is almost or more than almost 50%, which is very good for PvP. That's the reason why Fire Rune is better if you will be using Oberon in PvP. Also, you can use the Chakra as well, because to maximize the homecoming ultimate as well. Alright, so that's it for the equipment and room. Let's go with the divinity skills. So earlier I told you you can use the spotlight, right? That is for PvP. Alright, so for early game, I suggest you use this one, the Transcend, and then use this one, the Full Moon. Transcend and Full Moon, it will be enough for him in the early game. And then in the mid game, then you can use the Immortality Resonance, because most probably Oberon will be in front, and sometimes he might die too early. So 3 seconds of stun will be helpful in campaign, and then add this Full Moon. All right, and then in the end game, you can actually choose between Savvy and Spotlight. So Savvy, you can use this in campaigns together with Full Moon and then Transcend. For PvP, I suggest you use the Spotlight, Full Moon, and then Transcend. Alright, so those are the divinity skills that you can use for Oberon. Okay, so right now Oberon have a new skin that you can purchase. Unfortunately, if you were a free-to-play player and sorry for my dog. So if you are a free-to-play player and you were able to complete the Halloween event, you must have 60, let's say, what's that again? This one, the skin voucher, you must have already have 60 skin voucher. All you need to do is to get more of the skin voucher in the event here in the Snowman Journey. You must reach 5, 10, 15, 25, 35, at 215. I'm not sure if free-to-play players can reach 215, but this is the required skin voucher that we need for those free-to-play player who completed the Halloween event. If you're new, unfortunately, you won't be able to get a new skin for now. You would have to wait for another event like this in order to buy a skin for your hero. Alright, so let me just showcase Oberon here. Alright, so that's the spinning blade. So if you will be using the air rune, there's a possibility that Oberon will be using spinning blades consecutively, which is very good. Not only he will be immune to damages, he will reflect those damage back to enemy, which can deal a lot of damage. Alright, so the reason why I told you attack speed is not really important, because of that spinning blade. As you can see, if Oberon is using those spinning blades, he's not attacking normally. So yeah, it's not really important. As you can see, Oberon can only deal 3, maximum of 4 normal attacks. And then he will be using the spinning blades again. If you are using air rune, and then there is a possibility that Oberon will only be using 2 attack and then spin the blade again. Alright, so that's it. That's the end of my review for Oberon. If you have Oberon right now and you really want to use him, I suggest you increase her weapon to 400 as fast as you can, because that is where Oberon can be very beneficial to your team because of the survivability and dodges. Alright, that's it guys. If you have other suggestions for Oberon, please leave it in the comment down below. And if you're new to my channel, please hit the like button and subscribe. And thank you very much guys for watching. Advance Merry Christmas to you guys. And also I am actually asking if you want to help me gain my dream to have a new gaming equipment, you can actually click on the description below and you can put up a donation. Any amount will do. Thank you very much guys if you will be donating. All right so good luck for now. I love you guys. Hope for the best. We will see you back on my next video. Goodbye for now.